John James is a combat veteran and now a Michigan Senate candidate, was part of the first class at West Point to swear the oath of affirmation on after September 11th, with the understanding that he was going to be going to war. John James joins us now to reflect on these 17 years at war with terror. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Really
tell us your story.
Back.
Where were you? We all remember where we were when we heard the news.
Of course. Ironically, I was between my American politics class and my econ class. I remember
at West Point.
At West Point, yes. I graduated West Point in 2004, but before that, of course, in 2001, leaving class, I remember walking through the rotunda, walking up to Washington Hall, and hearing whispers and echoes in the hallway about planes hitting towers. And a lot of us thought it was a movie because it's surreal. Mm-hmm. It couldn't be real that a plane had hit a tower. By the time I got to econ class, everybody saw one tower smoking. No one really knew what was going on. And West Point is just 40 miles north of here, mm-hmm. right up the Hudson. And we watched as the next plane hit, and we stayed and we watched as one tower fell and the second tower fell. And we watched our American brothers and sisters die right before our eyes. But the thing that was really surreal to us is sitting right there in that classroom, we're thinking somebody has to do something about this, and silently realizing that we're the ones that America looks to do something about
and
this.
And what was that like when you realized I'm going to battle?
Well, as a 20-year-old, a 19, 20-year-old, you have to think about this. The people who are leading heroes into combat are just kind of kids themselves. Yeah. We ask our service members and our leaders to do so much, to take on obligations that are so heavy and big, but they do it because they love their country. It was an honor to serve with them. But walking back through the hallways with teenagers, 18, 19, 20-year-old sons and daughters of this nation who willingly take the oath and who are willing to lead and serve the best and brightest of America, looking back and forth and knowing that you had people who had your back and would always have your back. Mm-hmm. Not only do we swear that oath of affirmation, but our class, the class of 2004, we've lost the most among any class for the global war on terror. And I just want to remember my classmates and their families today.
Wow. So when you were in class, being that we had the embassy bombings in 97 and then you had the Cole bombing in 2000, were your professors, were your officer professors teaching you, hey, this is going to be the battle? This is coming to a head soon.
Great point. At West Point, we have a number of captains and majors and lieutenant colonels who are more seasoned, who've been preparing their entire careers to lead us into combat. Because as we come out as lieutenants, we look to these men and women to lead us effectively. After having that background, they understood the groundswell of terror that was coming around the world. This is a dangerous place. And as the world becomes a more and more dangerous place, we need combat veterans on the floor of the U.S. Senate who understands how to keep Americans safe because they've done it before. This is serious business. And so I'm prepared to do what I can to continue my service to the nation and to continue my service to my state. And it's an outstanding obligation and honor.
John, tell us a little bit about yourself, where you grew up. Why should people go to the polls and vote for you as the next senator?
Sure. I grew up in Detroit. I graduated from high school in 1999, graduated from West Point in 2004, became a Ranger qualified Apache pilot, and flew 750 hours of combat in Baghdad. I came back home because when I was over in Iraq, I was beamed back message on Fox and CNN and Armed Forces Network, areas of home, areas of Detroit, Pontiac, Flint, Benton Harbor, areas of home that looked worse than the combat zone I was flying in. And it really irked me that I didn't feel like there were enough folks fighting for Michiganders back home. And what did we need coming out of the Great Recession? We needed jobs. We needed someone who would fight for more jobs for Michiganders. So I went back home to join the family business, an automotive logistics company, and helped create 100 additional jobs and grew my family business from $35 million to $137
million. Whoa.
I believe that we need more people on the floor of the U.S. Senate who understands what it's like to sign the front and the back of a check, how to continue to make sure we take care of people and take care of our economy, Gora Marcus, but also someone who understands what it takes to keep America safe.
I know the president's a big believer in you. For your family, are they believing that you're a Republican? Because they were Democrats, right?
Well,
they are Democrats.
I was raised by parents who were abandoned by the Democratic Party. These are people who remember when Kennedy stood up in front of the nation and said, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. And this new far-left Democrat Party is asking the exact opposite. It's all about me.
Hand
it's
out.
All about I. It's all about free stuff, not a fair shot. And what we're about, the Republican Party, is a party of freedom. It's the party of emancipation. It's the party of suffrage. It's the party of unity and opportunity. And that is what I'm focused on bringing. Understanding, making tough life and death decisions in split seconds in the toughest of environments, from the battlefield to the boardroom. That's the skill set and temperament that we need representing Michigan on the floor of the U.S. Senate.
He would like to be the next U.S. Senator from the great state of Michigan. John James, thank you, sir,
yes,
for joining us live.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for your service.
It's hard to bet against you.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much.